Case in point, the facts are this. He was in our face in Baltimore, Sullivan went to the hospital, uncensored, he was out of control, and it's gonna go on and on and on. We want him in the ring, brother. Jimmy Hart's a man, 24 hours a day.
Get it done for Hart, get it done.
Let me promise you this, that there will be a vote next week by the executive board, and according to that vote is the way we will go. I will take your request, they will hear it, they will feel it, they will see it.
Well, you've got our number. Please call us as soon as you can.
We want to know what happens. Get it done, Bob. Whatever it takes.
Hi, everyone. WCW Saturday Night is on the air along with Bobby the Brain Heenan. This is Tony Schiavone, and you saw it last week. You saw it just at the top of the program. A week ago, Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage went to see Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel, wanted Ric Flair reinstated. But Commissioner Bockwinkel said, wait a minute, we have to have a vote. And we will have a vote this week as our cameras will go inside the WCW Executive Board and they'll vote on the reinstatement of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Tony, are you that dumb? Are you that blind? Can't you see what Hulk Hogan's doing? This is a smokescreen he's put up. He knows Bockwinkel can't make that kind of a decision. It'd have to go before the board. The board's not going to let Flair back. This is exactly what Hogan wants. Hogan does not want Ric Flair in the ring, outside the ring, or any place around the ring. Come on, wake up.
Well, of course, Ric Flair, of course, has been banned by Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel. However, Ric Flair is with us this week. How's that? He has purchased a segment on this program, and certainly we'll get his response to that. We cannot do anything about that. We'll have Ric Flair in his segment a little bit later on. Plus, Arn Anderson and Stunning Steve against Alex Wright and Johnny B. Badd in our main event.
How do I get in this room where they're voting?
You can't get in the room.
Well, I can't. I'm a broadcast journalist. I'm media.
No, I'm sorry. You can watch along with us. No, our cameras will be there.
There's got to be somebody at the door you can duke. You can grease their palm to get in there.
Absolutely. Fans, we have
somebody here. Let me lay you a little cash. Who's the guy at the door? Show me where the
door. No one at the door, Brain.
There's got to be a door.
Let's go to the ring. Our first bout tonight on WCW Saturday Night.
What's wrong? Change for a 10.
Gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one from Marstown, Tennessee, 214 pounds, Tim Connor. His tag team partner from Marietta, Georgia, 236 pounds, Rod Armstrong.
Well, what a way to open up Saturday night. You know this is April Fool's Day?
I could tell by your tie.
Hey, same tie I had on last week.
I know, I can still see the chili, the eggs, and the, they don't give you a check in a restaurant, do they?
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents for this tag team event to be accompanied by Sister Sherri from Harlem, New York.
Harlem Heat. They're going to have a pretty tough matchup here, Brain.
And don't think it on a woman, I'm not going to be a lady.
I'll get you good that, sucker.
Harlem Heat looks better than ever.
They really do. The World Tag Team Champions to open up this edition of WCW Saturday Night. Coming up in just a few moments, we will take you to the WCW Executive Board. The Executive Committee will make the vote. They will either vote Flair in or Flair out, based on the request that we had a week ago with Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage.
Well, how do you think they're going to vote, Schiavone?
Well, Brain, I don't know, but I can tell you this, and you probably know this already, we've talked a little bit about it, Ric Flair, even though Nick Bockwinkel a couple of weeks ago when Flair and Vader tried to put Dave Sullivan out of wrestling for good, even though Nick Bockwinkel threw him out of here, said he'll never be around again, Flair has bought a segment of this program,
paid for by Ric Flair. It's called Be Fair to Flair, and he's going to air that a little bit later on.
Well, you have to be fair to Flair.
No, you don't.
You have to be fair to Flair. Flair's the kind of guy you should be fair to.
Who's he ever been fair to? Who is?
He's been fair to this great sport for years. Here we go.
Sherri up on the apron of the ring. Harlem Heat against Tim Horner and Brad Armstrong to begin things, and we got a scrap going on already. Stevie Ray and Brad Armstrong back to a neutral corner here.
Well, Brad Armstrong and Tim Horner will come at you. They will fight you, but they're making a mistake. Harlem Heat is too big and bad for anybody. They proved that.
They sure have, over and over again. They prove they are the World Tag Team Champions, the best in WCW.
And they have the lovely lady of WCW.
Who's that?
Sherri.
You think she's the lovely lady of WCW? Look at that.
Of course. Yeah, her makeup's from the 90s. I mean, she's hip. She's with it. She's what's happening. She's cool.
I guess everybody has their own, and there you see what the fans think of Booker T. One half of the World Tag Team Champs, Booker T. Stevie Ray, Booker T, and Brad Armstrong work their way back now to a neutral far corner.
Bandages all over their bodies, courtesy of the Nasty Boys.
Yep. A couple of weeks ago, wild event on WCW Uncensored. Boy, Sherri's awfully noisy. Full arm dragon twist. Certainly, two men who like to use power, but also love to brawl.
And they're agile. They do aerial moves. They're tremendous tag team champions. Sherri does get beside herself sometimes.
Yes, she does. She gets pretty emphatic, pretty passionate about wrestling. Armbar into a hammerlock, and Brad Armstrong reversed it. And quickly, Booker T gets the break by going to the ropes.
Smart move.
Well, we're getting a little exchange of words here between Brad Armstrong and Stevie Ray on the outside. A lot of finger pointing and a little strategy session. She needs to get off the apron. Many people feel, and I'd like to address this with them if I can, many people feel that Booker T and Stevie Ray need to give the Nasty Boys a shot, another shot of the World Tag Team title, based on what happened at Uncensored.
They need to give them a shot in the mouth is what they need. Nasty Boys completely destroyed the whole concession area, and they're worthy of another championship match.
Yes, they are. Brad Armstrong goes crashing head first to a neutral corner, and
they're debating about Ric Flair, and they're going to consider the Nasty Boys. This isn't fair to Flair.
That's coming up, paid for by Flair. Brad rolls him up. What? Got a one count out of that. Ducked down for a drop toe hold out of the double axe handle.
The Harlem Heat's got to be careful, you know. They're coming off a big, tough match at Uncensored with the Nasties, and their bodies are all taped up and scarred up. And this team here of Horner and Armstrong can knock you off. They're going to be very careful with this team.
Tim Horner with a fireman's carry takeover. It's been all Booker. That's the only offense Stevie Ray's had. They've not been able to do that exchange they like to do.
Well, their bodies are still hurting, believe me.
There's their first tag, and here comes the big guy, Stevie Ray.
He just mauls you, don't he?
That's all he does, stands and pounds away. Booker T hanging in for a couple of extra counts. Tim Horner, who got the exchange from Brad, is in and goes down hard. Look at the ease of how the man can slam you down.
Tim, he's a big man.
Tim using his quickness, moving out of the way. And here comes Brad. Tim Horner and Brad Armstrong have been champions before. Double snapmare. Double elbow. Great
team. Ref.
What?
Two men in the ring for one team.
Two count.
For about 30 seconds. He doesn't do anything about it.
Oh, my. To the eyes.
Can't hit you if he can't see you.
That's exactly right. Whipping Brett Armstrong in by the hair. Booker T. Oh, my. Drop kick. Oh, no, it was a big foot. Maybe a knee that time. That caught Brett Armstrong after he turned to see Booker T. Clothesline. Down goes Brad.
And they can't waste too much time on a man like Brad Armstrong. You got him in a position to pin him, you better take advantage of him. Or he'll get right behind you and pin your shoulders real quick. Things don't look too good for him now.
Harlem sidekick. Put Brad down. Arrogant cover. It may have cost him. He got a two, but wasted a lot of time. And a reverse chin lock.
Well, he caught a good one right there in the yap. You know, they want Sherri to go to Paris, France next week to model all the spring fashion.
Where do you get the...
She told me that.
She told you that?
Yes.
And you believe her?
She's got her arms around you. You better listen.
Sherri had her arms around you?
Well, you know, in a friendly manner, you know.
Oh, I'm sure. Brad trying to fight out of this, but right now... Booker T is in control of this match. Picks him up. No, Brad held on. And picks up Booker T, who slides behind. Shoots him in.
Oh! Did he level him?
Brad head first out of the ring on the near side.
Well, we better get some security there and see if that floor's cracked.
Look at Sherri. Look at this. It's easy to slap a man when he's been thrown out of the ring on his head, basically. And now the ring post.
That's the most fun, when they're down.
So you advocate stomping a man when he's down, right?
He'll do it to you. It's just a matter of you getting there first. Look at this cat and mouse game here.
Really cocky right now, the World Tag Team Champions.
It seems to me they're wasting a little too much time. Keep him in your corner, especially a man like Armstrong.
The whip to the near side. Brad leaps over the top. Stevie Ray fighting to get a rope. He didn't get it. Throws him up. One. Quickly a save from Booker T.
Boy, that was desperation.
Pick up in a big slam.
He bounced.
That's just power. The force of that slam, and now Booker T back in. Harlem Heat, the World Tag Team Champs. No spare too much time.
But Armstrong's not sure where his corner is. Of course, he's never been known as the brightest guy in the world either.
Here's the exchange and the tag.
They let him go.
To the midsection. Right hand to the jaw. Back and forth, Tim Horner. Pick up and a big slam by Tim. He's going to pick the big guy up. Great move. Tim Horner. They call him White Lightning. And we got all four now, Brain.
I don't know who's leaving. I think it's Horner.
Oh, my. Tim slipped down, and Tim is on the back of Stevie Ray. The referee getting Brad Armstrong out.
Oh!
The scissors kick. And the cover. One, two,
they got him.
Three. They've got him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the World Tag Team Champions, Harlem Heat.
Just that last time, we got a fight, so these numbers going down. Number one.
They are number one. They are the World Tag Team Champs. And you think she's good looking?
Gorgeous.
All right, let's take a look once again, Brain, at what went down during the course of this matchup.
Armstrong goes for a suplex here. He's powerful enough. Harlem Heat is so agile. Shoves him right into that rope. And does he get him here in the side of the head, right to the temple? And that took the starch out of him right there. And here's the other member of Harlem Heat, dropping that big foot on the back. Just academic now. One, two, three. Let's go down and see what Tony Schiavone has to say with Harlem Heat and Sister Sherri.
Standing by with the World Tag Team Champions, the Sister Sherri. They are awesome, but many people feel, after Uncensored, the Nasty Boys deserve another World Tag Team title shot.
Everybody thinks the Nasty Boys deserve another tag team title shot. Well, that's fine with us, because tomorrow night on the main event, come on, Nasty Boy, you're going to get your wish, and you're going to wish you were ever born.
You know, Tony Schiavone, these belts represent professional wrestling's best. If I said it once, I said it 1,000 times. Nasty Boys, these belts mean everything to Harlem Heat and my sister. And you two fat punks can't get them, you ain't gonna get them. And I'm gonna tell you, brother, you don't want them, but you gonna get the shot that's gonna be heard all the way around the world tomorrow night on the main event, baby. Yeah. Like my brother said, I normally would say, you ain't got them and you ain't gonna get them. But after the main event, you gon' get it, all right? Because a couple of straight OG brothers from across 110th Street, Harlem, New York, gon' take it to you. Like I always say, it ain't nothing but a thing, like a chicken wing on a string, if you understand what I'm saying.
And it ain't nothing to it, baby, but to do it. Come on, bring it on.
Okay, the challenge has been made to the Nasty Boys for tomorrow night on the main event. And the Nasty Boys will be here a little bit later on. More on Saturday night, right after this. Time out.
Come on, Nasty!
Don't change that dial. In a little while, Das Wonder Kid and Johnny B. Bad take on Stunning Steve Austin and my favorite puncher bag, Arn Anderson. Be there!